In this layer for side video, I'm going to show you how to improve your MCAT score by 1 point. Wait, just 1 point? I want you to think for a second. You've been studying for a while, you're taking practice tests, and you just can't get out of the plateau. So you go on YouTube, and you find these videos promising a 520 in some very short amount of time, or a jump in 10 points with just 3 weeks of studying, and you get excited, you get hopeful. But you're also a little overwhelmed because deep down, you know this isn't going to work. Here's the problem I see when most students work on their full lengths. They try to fix everything. Tell me if that's you in the comments below. You finish a full length, you don't even take a break, you go right into review, and you fill out one of those massive why I missed it spreadsheets. Every single question, what you got wrong, why you got it wrong, what you have to study, which topic it falls under, so much information. That if you go through the entire spreadsheet, you study it, you work on it, and you take this exam again, you will get a 528. The problem is, this spreadsheet is so overwhelming, you're not gonna have time to go back to it. And even if you do, the idea is so overwhelmingly scary that you're not motivated to continue. Now, most students have their full lengths so frequently that you don't even have time to work on everything. And before you know it, you're taking another full length, filling out another table, having even more things on that overwhelming spreadsheet, and you just, well, you're stuck in a plateau. Because when you're all over the place, you wind up fixing nothing. And this is why, when I work with students to help them bring up their MCAT score, I'm not looking to fix everything, I am looking to find 1 point. Because what is better than being stuck in a scoring plateau, having a slow and steady, realistic trajectory where you're constantly improving, getting better, and seeing the results? The review method that I use, as well as the table to fill out, are available on my website at layerforsci.com/MCATFL. After you complete your full-length review table, I want you to take a step back and analyze each section as a whole. And I want you to ask yourself, what is the one biggest issue that stands out so that if I work on nothing else this week except this one thing, my score will go up by 1 point? Now, it might not happen for every section, but if you try to specifically work on one issue per section and just one section is improved enough to raise your score, that is your 1 point. And because you only have one thing to focus on in each section, your mind is not all over the place, you're not completely scattered, you have enough time and attention to work on this one thing, and your scores will go up. Let's take a look at the full-length review table of one of my study hall members. Looking at this table, we see that the student missed questions in so many different areas that it would take her so long to improve. Of course, she's going to review the individual questions and answers, but what to focus on next is going to determine her success moving forward. Take a look at the ChemPhys section, for example. We have questions missed in the content section from material studied but forgot, or concepts misunderstood, formulas and equations forgotten, or application and manipulation issues, calculation setup errors, not sure how to apply graphs and tables, questions taking too long, misreading and misunderstanding passages or questions. Now what? If she tried to focus on everything, she'd be all over the place and completely lost. So instead, we try to categorize what is going on and pick the one area of focus. In the content area, we have a total of 10 questions missed. That is because a forgotten equation is a fact forgotten, and so we have 10 right here. But in the timing issues, we have 11. The only thing I had her work on before her next full length was timing, specifically on questions for the ChemPhys section. Yes, she was still doing passages, reviewing the passages and the content that came along with it, but her primary focus, the bulk of her effort for the ChemPhys section, was timing as it related to questions taking too long. In the cars section, she only categorized it as reasoning within the text, beyond the text, and foundations of comprehension. But within the text at 12 questions was her biggest issue. The only thing I had her focus on was getting comfortable with reasoning within the text by doing critical reading of articles, as well as focusing on understanding the passages when she did practice. For the bio-biochem section, we have 5 missed content, 2 calculation setup error, 2 graphs and tables, but 11 between misreading and misunderstanding passages and answer choices.
Since she's already focusing on critical reading and understanding passages for the cards section, I had her focus specifically on better breaking down the questions. And finally, in the psych-soc section, we have 7 related to content, 2 related to graphs and tables, and 7 again for misreading and misunderstanding. In this case, it's a choice between content and misreading misunderstanding. And we chose to focus on content because the effort that went into improving bio-biochem should also translate to psych-soc. This way she's not all over the place and gets to hone in on that one thing per section. And if you look at her next full length, were we successful in hunting for 1 point? Chem-phys went up a point, CARS went up a point, bio-biochem went up a point, and psych-soc held steady. This is not a typical improvement. You'll usually see a jump in one area, but hey, she had no complaints.
Now that you know what to do, I want you to go back to your most recent full length and redo the review. Not the entire review. Just scan the questions that you got wrong to categorize why you got it wrong. Take that step back and go hunting for a point. If you're ready to go on the hunt with me, first, give this video a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe to my channel and click that bell icon so you don't miss out on any new videos. Then go to layerforsci.com/MCATFL for a quick review on how to review that full length, as well as a template for the table to fill out so that you can go on the hunt. If you want my help reviewing your full length review table, as well as coming up with a strategic plan so you know exactly what to do next, come work with me in the MCAT study hall because this is exactly what we do in office hours. Full study hall details are available on my website, join.mcatstudyhall.com. You can see the link below or go to join.mcatstudyhall.com.